Good morning, friends. In today's class, we are going to start a new topic called as application of derivatives. In application of derivatives, again, we are having lot of subtopics. The main subtopic is tangent and normals. In 11th class, we learned about tangent and normal in coordinate geometry. What do you mean by a tangent? If suppose I take a curve, call that curve as y is equal to f of x. If I draw a straight line in such a way that this particular straight line touches the curve at a single point, that means touches the curve at this particular point or at a particular point, then you can call this straight line as tangent to the curve. Tangent to the curve. Now, any line perpendicular to the tangent, any line perpendicular to the tangent to the curve is known as, any line perpendicular to the tangent to the curve is known as normal. And if suppose y is equal to f of x is our curve, then dy by dx is equal to f dash x represents slope of the tangent of the curve. And if suppose a point is given to us, we need to require the equation of the tangent to the curve, then how we can find out means, we should use a formula y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1, where m is nothing but dy by dx. All these things we have learned in our 11th class. So once again, we shall start doing numericals based on this particular chapter, tangent and normals. A small question we will be taking. He is asking us to find the slope of the tangent to the curve y is equal to x cube minus x at x is equal to 2. So what should we do means, given y is equal to x cube minus x, we differentiate with respect to x. So dy by dx is equal to x cube ka derivative 3x square minus 1. Now dy by dx always represents slope, but we are required to find slope of the tangent to the curve at the point x is equal to 2. That means wherever we are having x, we need to substitute that particular value. That means dy by dx at x is equal to 2 is given as 3 into 2 square minus 1. That means 3 into 4, 12. 12 minus 1 is 11. Therefore, slope of the tangent to the curve is always given by dy by dx, and the value is obtained as 11. Right, another problem we shall be seeing. Find the slope of the tangent and normal to the curve y equal to 2x square plus 3 sin x at x is equal to 0. Right, how we will be doing means, given y is equal to 2x square plus 3 sin x, from this I shall differentiate with respect to x. So dy by dx is equal to 4x plus 3 cos x, because x square ka derivative 4, x square ka derivative 2x, 2x into 2, 4x, sin x ka derivative cos x, so 4x plus 3 cos x. Now later, what I'll be doing means, this is a slope, dy by dx always represents slope, but we require slope of the tangent at the particular point x is equal to 0. So what I'll be doing means, dy by dx at x is equal to 0, I'll be finding out. Dy by dx at x is equal to 0 means, wherever we are finding x, there we need to keep 0. That means what happens, 4 into 0 plus 3 into cos 0. That means 4 into 0, 0, 3 into cos 0 means 3 into 1, so that will be 3. Therefore, dy by dx at x is equal to 0 is 3. That is nothing but slope of tangent. That is nothing but slope of tangent, and it is given by m, but here I will write as m1. But we know that tangent is perpendicular to normal, or normal is perpendicular to tangent. Let the slope of normal be m2. But we know that tangent slope and normal slope, and tangent and normal are perpendicular to each other. Therefore, what I will be doing, m1 into m2 is equal to minus 1, because two lines are perpendicular, if and only if product of slopes equal to minus 1. But m1 what I obtained, 3. m2 means as usual that is equal to minus 1, that implies m2 is equal to minus 1 by 3, which is the slope of the normal. Slope of the tangent is 3 and slope of the normal is minus 1 by 3. So whenever we are asked to find slope of the normal, try to find slope of the tangent and then apply the condition m1 m2 equal to minus 1, then you will be getting the required answer. Right now we shall be seeing a very short answer question, which is very important. Find the points on the curve x square by 4 plus y square by 25 equal to 1 at which tangents are parallel to x axis and tangents are parallel to y axis. If you could observe carefully, the curve is generally representing an ellipse. What it tells me is, suppose this is the required ellipse, right? We need to find the equation of the tangent which is parallel to x axis. That means we need to find the equation of this particular line, right? And another time, we need to find the equation of the tangents which are parallel to y axis. Which are parallel to y axis means the line goes like this, or the line goes like this, right? So we shall try to solve this particular problem. Now how we will be doing means, given x square by 4 plus y square by 25 equal to 1, I want to find the derivative. X square derivative 2x, 2x by 4 plus 2y by 25 into dy by dx equal to 0. So what happens finally, this is x by 2 plus or what I'll be doing means, just I will eliminate 2. So what happens, x by 4 plus y by 25 into dy by dx equal to 0. So from here what can I tell, y by 25 into dy by dx is equal to minus x by 4. So later dy by dx is equal to minus 25x divided by 4y. Once again I am repeating, x square derivative 2x, 2x by 4, y square derivative 2y, 2y by 25 into dy by dx is equal to 0. So 2 I am eliminating, that means sending to that side. So what happens, x by 4 plus y by 25 into dy by dx is equal to 0. So y by 25 dy by dx is equal to minus x by 4. So dy by dx is equal to minus 25x divided by 4y. Now in the first problem, what given tangent is parallel to x-axis, tangent is parallel to x-axis means slope of the tangent is equal to slope of the x-axis. That means slope of tangent is equal to slope of x-axis, but slope of x-axis is 0 and slope of tangent is minus 25x by 4y. So cross multiplication, minus 25x is equal to 0. So finally we will be getting the value of x is equal to 0. As we are getting the value of x is equal to 0, we will be getting y values by substituting in the curve. When I substitute all these things in the curve, what happens, y square is equal to 25 and I will be getting y is equal to plus or minus 5. Therefore points can be 0 comma 5 or 0 comma minus 5. Now we will be doing, I will be substituting x is equal to 0 in the given curve. Now what I will be doing, put x is equal to 0 in 1. If I put x is equal to 0 in 1, what happens, y square by 25 equal to 1 is equal to 1. So what happens, y square is equal to 25, that implies y is equal to plus or minus 5. Therefore points on the curve, therefore final conclusion here I am writing, therefore points on the curve where the tangents are parallel to x-axis, is given by when I say plus or minus 5 is there. So one point will be 0 comma 5 and another point will be 0 comma minus 5. I think you are clear with this. Now, if suppose in the second question, what is telling parallel to y-axis? That means a slope of tangent, how we should write? Given tangent is parallel to y-axis. I am continuing here. Given tangent is parallel to y-axis. That means slope of the tangent is equal to slope of y-axis. Slope of y-axis is always undefined. As it is undefined, I will be taking 1 by 0. As if I take 1 by 0, then what happens? I can cross multiply. If I cross multiply, what I will be getting? Finally, here, finally cross multiplying, what I will be getting? 4y equal to 0. 4y equal to 0 means what happens? Y equal to 0. Now, what I will be doing? Put y equal to 0 in 1. If I put y is equal to 0 in 1, then what happens? X square by 4 plus 0 by 25 equal to 1. So for us, what remains? X square by 4 equal to 1. X square by 4 equal to 1 means what happens? X square is equal to 4. X square is equal to 4. X square is equal to 4 means what happens? X is equal to plus or minus 2. Therefore, finally, what should I write? Points on the curve where tangents are parallel to y-axis. Tangents on the curve where points on the curve where tangents are parallel to y-axis are given by this time. In place of x, first time I need to take 0, y means always 0, and here I need to take minus 2, and here it becomes 0. So it's a very, very important problem. Everyone pay attention while doing this problem.